Hey guys, Ivan here, and in this video we're gonna check out what Chris Bumstead is looking like 3 months after the Mr. Olympia. Now I'm assuming, and I think it's a pretty safe assumption, that he's off the gear here. So he was talking about being on only testosterone during the off season. That's all he was taking. Him and his brother-in-law and coach Ian Valier talked about this in a podcast. They said that Chris was only doing 500 mgs of test per week during the off season. Unfortunately, they didn't talk about what he was taking during the prep and how much he was taking, but they were clear that he was taking less during the off season and of course much more during the contest prep to get in that crazy shape and to win the Mr. Olympia. But the reason why he's taking so little stuff in the off season is, well, there are two reasons. First off, he doesn't have to grow much more. I mean, he's already right there, very close to the weight cap. He can't really grow anymore. I mean, maybe like a pound or two, that's it. And also, he has that kidney disease, so he cannot push the gear too much. You know, it's dangerous for him. He's not very healthy. So let's say he's actually using those very small amounts of tests during the off-season, and then let's assume that he was taking a few grams of gear during the prep, and of course more toxic stuff. So if he did that, and if he's so health conscious, and if he doesn't have to grow, I'm pretty sure he's going completely off after the Mr. Olympia for a couple of months, doing the PCT, doing the stuff to improve his health, not pushing the training, not pushing the food, which is something he talks about in this caption of this photo. So he says, 3 months post-Olympia, weighing almost exactly the same as my stage weight, just a fair amount of muscle loss. I forgot my scale in Orlando after the Olympia and I hadn't weighed myself until last week. Current weight is 237. I've kept my diet on point, so I didn't end up looking like a poop emoji, while I was barely training and to properly reverse diet so my body was primed and ready for a good off season. Now starting my off season, my digestion, appetite is great, even though I can't taste. Body fat percent is at a great spot to start adding mass, and my body feels rested and ready to grow. Plenty of aspects I can be better at this year, and I'm excited to apply them. Alright, so that's what he says. He thinks he can improve, he can work on some other aspects. We'll see about that, we're gonna talk about that in a moment. Before we get to that, let's take a look at his physique real quick. So, here you can see that he's, well, he's in a good shape. So, he's about 30 pounds lighter, maybe less than 30 pounds, 20 something pounds lighter than he used to be during the off season, with a similar, maybe a little bit better body fat percent. So he didn't really lose a lot of muscle, he did lose some, but as he says, he wasn't training almost at all, and he probably wasn't pushing the food, and I have no idea what the hell was he doing with the gear, but I'm guessing he went off. Did he really go off? Well, if he really went off, and this is coming from my personal experience, and experience of my friends and people that I know who are taking stuff, if he really went off after the cycle, after the competition, and if he didn't train very often, as he says he didn't, and if he wasn't on a specific diet, if he was eating whatever, if he was eating junk food all the time and everything like that, he wouldn't look close to this. He would look horrible. I'm sure he would. It always happens. No matter who you are, how good your genetics are, if you are on a heavy cycle and you go off, your testosterone levels, natural levels, are gonna go super low. And if you are eating horribly, you're gonna look like that as well. That's not something Chris did. So he was on a diet. He wasn't training very hard and very often, but he was still on a good diet. And let's assume he actually went off. I think this is possible. I think he is off here because he has 20 to 25 pounds of muscle lost from the off season till now. So he just lost muscle, but he didn't gain a lot of fat. So he probably took this photo after training with a chest or an arm pump, and he found a good lighting, good angle. He flexed his quads, he flexed his abs, he made his arm look better at the angle, and this is what he looks like. And he looks great, he looks awesome. So I'm sure a lot of people are not even thinking, he didn't specify in the caption he was off. So maybe people are thinking that he's on TRT, maybe he is, but is it possible for him to look like this off? If his diet is on point, sure, it's possible. He has a lot of muscle, So when he loses some muscle, it doesn't look that bad. As long as his body fat percent is low enough, he's gonna look great. Maybe he won't look as full, as round, as hard, as vascular and stuff like he would if he was on, but he does look great. Body fat percent is low, he's a smaller downsized version of Chris Bumstead, but lean and a little bit smaller, but still muscular, and this is good. This is a good version of him. I don't know if you guys noticed, but Chris Bumstead, unless he's completely shredded, his legs do not have a lot of detail. In the off-season, he pretty much has none. But this is actually 2 weeks out. Now, I don't know if he's retaining a lot of water down there in the lower body because of his kidney issue, or is it simply a genetic factor? He loses fat last in that area. I don't know, but usually, in the off-season, his legs are big and round, but they have pretty much no detail. As he's approaching the show, that starts to change. And this is him right here, 2 weeks out of Mr. Olympia. Would these details be enough for him to win the Mr. Olympia? I don't think so. I really doubt that. I think the judges would knock him for this. But when the time comes, he is ready. At the show, he's always shredded. Why am I talking about this? Why am I talking about his shredded legs and details? It's because right now, 3 months after the Mr. Olympia, before his offseason even started, when he's probably off of everything, he has really good leg details. You can see all four heads of the quadriceps. You can also see that left vastus medialis, or the teardrop. You can see that little line in the middle. That means he's really lean. Like, if that line looks like that, it looks hard, you know, his legs look sharp. His body fat percent is low, man, like really low. You can also see the veins in the adductor area, which is something that comes pretty much last. Unless you have a ton of muscle right there, it's similar like glutes. Like, that's the last, one of the last areas where you can see the definition, you know, the cuts. Usually when somebody is not on shape on the stage, you can see that that area, the inner part of the quads, is looking smooth, there are no veins, but if you can see the veins, and if you can see some striations, some cuts, that means that somebody is in shape. And Chris is really lean right now, 3 months post-show. Now, I don't know if I would say the same thing about his upper body. Yes, he's not even shaven, and he doesn't have very deep abs. That's genetic. He has a great vacuum, so who cares? Even though the fur is covering his definition, you can still see that he still has some fat in the stomach area. Usually, when somebody has a really strong midsection, really developed abs, they don't store as much fat in that area, but Chris doesn't have a lot of muscle there, so probably that's why he packs some fat right there. If you saw, when you saw his legs, if you didn't see his upper body, if you just saw the legs, you would guess he has great six-pack, but that's not the case with him. Both legs and abs are two areas where Chris is holding the most amount of fat, but apparently he's holding more on his abs, I would say. Now, as far as chest, he has a good amount of muscle there. He's very chest dominant. That's probably his best, his most dominant body part along with legs. So chest is looking great. Even though he's downsized, he still has great chest. And arms, which is his worst body part, the arms are looking pretty good right now as well. Now, he maybe have an arm pump, I don't know. Yeah, the shoulders and the arms are looking a little bit, I wouldn't really use the word melted, just not as full. I mean, he is not eating heavy, he's not training very hard, so of course he got a little flatter. And yeah, he's looking a little flat, but still, he's holding on to a lot of muscle, his body fat percent is great, and he's not pushing anything. No, no training, no food, and not even gear, I'm guessing. So once he starts doing all those three, and his off-season is ready to start, he's going to blow up, I'm guessing. Now, he cannot get as big as he would probably like to, because of the kidneys, because of the weight cap, but as he says in this caption, there are plenty of aspects that he can actually improve on. What are those? I'm guessing just details, maybe getting bigger arms, maybe getting more details in the quads, in the hamstrings, in the glutes, in the chest, in the back, I don't know. But, you know, it's not adding mass. Maybe adding some mass in biceps and triceps, but he's gotta be talking about improving the maturity, you know, getting those cuts even deeper, those striations more prominent, the skin to get thinner, and the stuff of that sort. Yeah, he said that one day he will do the Open. He will do the Arnold Classic Open division, but it's not gonna happen this year, no, because right now he's definitely downsized. Now, in that photo with perfect lighting, with probably a pump, he doesn't look that small, but here in a t-shirt and shorts, he's not looking very big. He definitely does look quite a bit downsized. This is Chris Bumstead back in 2016. The show is called Diana Caddo Classic, where he placed third in Classic Physique. 2016 was the year when Classic Physique was created, but Chris didn't compete at the Mr. Olympia. He competed in 2017, where he was second. He repeated the same result in 2018, and then the next 3 years he won, as you I'm sure know. But this is him 2016. Now, this is not very impressive. As I said, he was third. And this sort of reminds me of his shape right now. He's, especially you can see his shoulders are looking more round, and he's overall, like, he's very full. He probably carved up heavily. He was probably using more gear back in the day when he was healthy, when he didn't know about his kidney disease. No, his arms are not as good as they are today, so he definitely improved in that area. And yeah, maybe he's fuller and he's ready for the stage, but imagine if he did a depletion and then a crazy carb up, if he of course shaved his body and put on a protein and a glaze and pumped up and stepped on the stage, which version would look better? I don't know, honestly. I don't know. Maybe today Chris Bumstead is so much better than 3 months after show, not even training hard, not eating a lot, being off completely. He's looking better than he looked how many, 5-6 years ago, when he was full-blown on stage, placing third on a very low-level show. So there you go, guys. This is Chris right now. He's looking really good for considering everything. I mean, he looks really good, really good. And what do you guys think? What do you think about his downsized version? Do you think he really lost that much muscle? Do you believe that he's off? He didn't say it, but I'm guessing. Do you think he's off completely? And what do you think are the aspects that he can actually improve on? That's I'm curious about that. We'll see what's going to happen next year. I hope he will have the drive to push things again, because, you know, I mean, he achieved everything pretty much. He doesn't have a lot more to prove. So I don't know where he will find the motivation and the drive to actually go through the hell to get ready for the stage again and to win the Mr. Olympia. But, you know, we'll see in about a year. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like. And for more bodybuilding stuff like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. All the best and bye-bye.